Indeed, it's an honor being here this morning to share a little of God's word with you. My name is Joy, as Sister Angela just said. Most of you know me. I'm friends with quite a few of you. God bless each and everyone. I'm going to share from one of my devotional reading that I do every morning. And most of the times I post from Barbara Walsh Ministries. I usually post that on Joy Gospel Radio FM website. And today I'm sharing one with you because it has touched my life because of situations that I'm going through. And it's a reminder to me. And what I'm going to read to you is it's entitled Recognizing Unforgiveness. And the reading says, There are some who think they have forgiven a past wrong, but in reality, it is still lying dormant in their hearts, becoming more bitter, decayed, and smelly by the hour. People who won't forgive are miserable, and it affects every aspect of their lives, as well as those around them. If you hear something bad has happened to a person that hurt you, and your heart wants to scream, yes, he finally got what he deserved, then you really haven't forgiven. Because when you truly forgive, you will not harbor bitterness, nor will you wish them ill will. Instead, you will love them with the love of God, even when it's impossible to love with human love. Sometimes the pain has accumulated over time, and even though you've given, a memory may come up again and again that's so painful, it creates the need to forgive all over again. If you choose not to forgive, the Bible says in Matthew 6:15, but if you do not forgive others their sins, your Father will not forgive your sins. In other words, forgiving is so important to God that he has made it a requirement for your entrance fee to heaven. What do we need to do? Pray and ask God to reveal any unforgiveness in our hearts. And then he will give you the strength and courage to forgive. And there's a few texts that comes with that reading. I'm going to read the text to you, and then I'm going to explain a little. And the Bible text, the first one is coming from 1 John 3:15 from the New King James Version. It says, whoever hates his brother is a murderer. And you know that no murderer has eternal life abiding in him. And in Matthew 5:44-45, in the New King James Version, it says, but I say to you, love your enemies, bless those who curse you, do good to those who hate you, and pray for those who spitefully use you and persecute you, that you may be sons of your Father in heaven. For he makes his sun rise on the evil and on the good, and sends rain on the just and on the unjust. And in 1 John 2:9-11, it says, he who says he is in the light and hates his brother is in darkness until now. He who loves his brother abides in the light, and there is no cause for stumbling in him. But he who hates his brother is in darkness and walks in darkness and does not know where he is going, because the darkness has blinded his eyes. And the last verse is coming from Mark 11:25. And it says, and whenever you stand praying, if you have anything against anyone, you need to forgive him, that your Father in heaven may also forgive you your trespasses. That ends the reading. My dear brothers and sisters, forgiveness is a state of pardon. In Matthew 18:21-22, when Peter asked the Lord, how often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him? Till seven times? Jesus answered Peter and he said, I sin not unto thee until seven times, but until 70 times seven. Many times people done us wrong and we hold on to that. We don't forgive them. But if we keep holding on to the wrongs they do, how do we expect God to forgive us? You know, I have a situation that's going on. It's an ongoing situation. And even yesterday, the temptation came. And I said, you know, I spoke to someone, I said, I'm about to present the same reading of unforgiveness. And if I keep not forgiving that person, God is not going to forgive me, because we all come short of God's glory. We all do wrong. You know? And even though Jesus said to forgive those who sin against us 70 times seven, he was not limiting forgiveness. Christians with forgiving hearts do not limit the number of times they forgive. We need to continue to forgive as much, with as much grace over and over. And as long as we have the Spirit of God living or dwelling within us, it should not be hard to forgive our fellow brothers and sisters, because God forgave us over and over and over. I don't think there's any one of us that can say God hasn't forgiven them or he's not forgiving them over and over. Because we all sin. We sin by word. Sometimes we sin by thought. Sometimes the things we do, we all sin and come short of God's glory. So if we cannot forgive our brothers and sisters, how do we expect God to forgive us? We need that peace of mind. We do not want hatred to always step in, you know? If that step in, sometimes folks can lose their lives over unforgiveness. What we all need to do is to pray. Pray and ask God for that forgiving spirit, so we would not walk around with that heavy heart of not forgiving our fellow man. There are a few additional texts that I want to leave with you today that tells about unforgiveness. In Psalms 134, it tells us that you need to forgive. In Mark 3:29, it talks about forgiveness also. In Acts 5:31, Acts 13:38, Acts 26:18. And Ephesians 1:7. Ephesians 1:7 says, in whom we have redemption through his blood and forgiveness of sin according to the riches of his grace. So we need to trust God for his word. We need to forgive. I know it's hard because I'm telling you, I'm there. But we just need to pray and ask God for that forgiving spirit. We need to pray and ask him to mold us and to always keep us. May God help us. Help us all to give us that level of forgiveness to our fellow man. Let us pray. Dear Father and God, this morning we come before you saying, thank you, God, for this day. Dear God, we say thank you for life. Dear Father God, we ask you humbly that you forgive all our sins. Create in us, dear God, clean hearts, and only let your Holy Spirit dwell within. Fill us, dear God, fill us with your Holy Spirit, and give us the strength and courage we need to be great ambassadors for your kingdom, dear Father God. We thank you, God, for your love, for your kindness, for your graciousness, for your mercies. Father God, I give you praise and thanks for Joy Gospel Radio FM. I give you praise and thanks, and I pray and I ask you to touch each and every member, dear God. And this little reading that I brought this morning, dear God, I hope that it touches someone's heart as it touched mine. And we ask that you continue to keep us, dear God. Keep us. Strengthen us, Father God. Lord, I present all the ministers of this program. I present Evangelist Angela foremost. I present all the other pastors, bishops, ministers that comes on here with your word. And for the future people who are like myself, dear Father God, who are now learning more about you, that when they come on, we would all listen attentively and you would accept whatever you fill their spirit, their heart with, dear God. Continue to keep us. Guide us throughout this day, dear Father God. I pray for your Son, Christ Jesus. I give you praise and I give you thanks. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.